Ich mute mich hier mal und dann sagst du einfach irgendwas auf dem Stream. Bis
Ah,
gleich.
es sollte gehen jetzt. Es zeigt ja an im OBS, wenn man redet.
Klaus?
Bin mir ziemlich sicher, dass es geht. Eins, zwei, drei, vier, fünf, sechs,
Es geht,
sieben.
es geht, es geht, es geht. Konnte man gut hören. Also, ich lade dich ein, dann können wir. Es hat ganz, ganz, ganz grässlich gespielt und abgewehrt, hätte ich auch nicht gewinnen dürfen, das Spiel. Geht um Proxy Reaper. Und wollte ich halt den Leuten nochmal zeigen, wie man das richtig abwehrt.
Oh, Proxy Reaper, aber auch noch nicht rausgefunden, wie man es abwehrt. Das
Ja,
spielt fast
doch.
niemand.
Ja, gut. Aber gegen mich wirst du es herausfinden. Also du wirst
Ja.
da, wir reagieren ja immer letztendlich in den unteren Ligen auf Cheese mit zwei Gas und Roche und so fort. Ne? Und dann wirst du halt gucken, wie wir das dann durchspielen. Ne? Also kannst dich dann auch frei entscheiden. Wir können auch sagen, Leute, so ab Diamond könnt ihr gegen Cheese dann reagieren, wie ihr wollt. Oder die Transition ist dann egal. Gucken wir uns einfach an. Okay, oder willst du das Replay zuerst sehen oder wie so, oder sollen wir direkt normal in die Ladder gehen? Was möchtest du?
Ja, schauen wir, ist das Replay? Mir ist egal, aber ich glaube, ich weiß, was du meinst. Also ein
Okay.
FreeRex Proxy, oder?
Sowas in die Richtung. Könnte auch Forex sein, könnte auch Turex sein, weiß ich jetzt nicht auswendig. Gescoutet habe ich das, aber reagiert habe ich schrecklich. Also ich bin froh, dass du noch jung bist und noch keinen Herzinfarkt kriegen kannst. Gut. Ja, dann gehe ich auf Watch with Others, starte das Spiel, beziehungsweise gebe dir Lead. Und dann kannst du das Intro machen, Promote to Lobby Host. Und ich bin bereit.
Okay, also Intro, Cheese
Machst
Defense.
du.
Was soll ich genau sagen?
Das ist eine gute Frage, gute Frage. Ich würde schon sagen, LOTV Occo Style und Reacting to Cheese oder sowas, oder Cheese Defense, ja. Ist eine gute Idee.
Okay. Hello guys, this is Yoga Style 2.0 and we're learning how to react to cheese. With me is Neoblade. Hello, Neoblade.
Hello, Mamba. We jump to my vision, I think. I react very badly to this cheese, though I scout it. But I think you guys out there will have problems scouting cheese and reacting the right way will be difficult for you too. This is Proxy Barracks. And yeah. We had some cheese played against us or some all-ins, and sometimes you decided to take two gas right away and build roaches instantly.
Yes.
I remember one game at Orbital Shipyard.
Yeah, I think. Oh, what are you doing?
Sometimes I have problems with the opening when I try to focus on my overlord too much. It's still a problem for me. I have to train the opening against the computer AI, but I play so much Overwatch, I get distracted of training StarCraft
Yeah,
regularly.
so I mean your pull was way too late.
Yeah.
Like yeah, you can already pretty much. Yeah, it's just very difficult. I mean now you've done the macro hatch. Okay,
Yeah.
I see where this went wrong. I think that's not so much about the Reapers.
Game paused.
More about, I don't know, maybe you were distracted in the early game, like tapping in, tapping out. Like the first thing I noticed is you didn't send out your first overlord right away. Like you set camera hotkeys first.
Yeah.
Like you always send your first overlord to your
or
opponent's
right away
natural.
To your opponent. Yeah, okay. Very, very good tip.
Yeah, like this is important, like just for even in the lower leagues, because if you don't send it right away, if you wait like 15 seconds, then you can lose your overlord against a marine, for example.
Yeah.
But that was not like the reason now why you lost. Like the reason why you lost is you didn't put down your pool until you had like 400
Game
minerals.
paused.
Like,
Game paused.
Game resumed.
Yeah, like you put down your spawning pool at
Game paused.
430 minerals.
And 20 supply.
And then I mean everything went wrong from there. Like you panicked, though you had 700 minerals because you couldn't build queens and links. And then you built a macro hatchery and pulled your drones down to the natural, and then you had no more minerals to build anything
that
else.
I was building a bunker, so I wanted to defend it with the drones.
Game resumed.
I understood that, but like with pulling the drones away plus the macro hatch and then like the double gas and the spine trawlers, you had no more minerals. I think the right call how to defend is to get one gas and the roach run immediately. Like usually we get two gas and the roach run to defend any kind of cheese.
Okay.
But this is like this hits so early, we are on such a low drone count that one gas is enough. Like
okay.
two gas, then this would mean we have 10 drones at the minerals and 6 in the gas. Like roaches, they just cost a little bit gas, not too much.
Okay.
So I think 2 gas is too much. But that's not about where it went wrong in this game. I'm just
400
explaining.
You have to play the first 30 supply perfectly. There's no doubt about it. It's okay in bronze to have problems, but when you're in the silver league, you should have about, I think, 100 games or so, and then you have to build the first 30 supply perfectly. And yeah, I think if you want to become a better StarCraft 2 player, you really have to practice against an AI so you can keep calm and so on. I built the macro hatch because I know I wouldn't have queens, and I know this is a cheese and I need larva.
Oh, but
so
the thing is you don't have queens
paused.
Because you built a macro hatchery.
Ah, okay. And I didn't have a pool.
Yeah,
yeah.
But the thing is your pool was too late, and because your pool was too late you couldn't build queens, and then you had like 700 overmints, and then you panicked and put down the macro hatchery. Like you shouldn't have done this. Like because you could have spent all the minerals anyway when the pool depleted.
Finishes and yeah, and building queens is more important than a macro hatch, of course.
Yeah.
Yeah,
of course. Like the macro hatch is like so greedy. You can't invest 300 in the minerals into something that doesn't fight. And one spine crawler is okay. But
spine
not necessary. I don't think.
And
I don't think necessary, or I don't think the spank trawlers are necessary. I think it's just queens, put down the roach one immediately, and mine from one gas, and then defend with links until you have roaches, and then defend with roaches.
Okay.
This is the difference in Heart of the Swarm and Legacy of the Void. In Heart of the Swarm, defended Reapers with speed, with Surging Speed. The moment you got Surging Speed, you won. If you survive at that point.
Yeah.
Because you can surround the Reapers and then kill them. And now, because of the Reaper ground rates, like 10 Reapers are very powerful even against Speedlings. Then you can throw the grenades and kill all your Speedlings.
Yeah.
So the answer to Reaper's Legacy of the Void is roaches and ravagers.
Okay.
But like the that's not very bad wrong. Like, it went wrong from the very start.
Yeah.
You weren't focused in the first 2 minutes of the game.
If
you got cheesed in a game where you fucked up the first 2 minutes, you always die. That's just how it is.
Yeah. Okay, I think we can leave the game now, and I will play this against you so you can see the right response. I will build the barracks at the same position using the same map. I'm not the best proxy. I'm not the best Terran and not the best proxy Reaper guy. So, you open it or?
You have a lead. Okay. If you give me a lead, I can open it.
Yeah, I think I can do it too.
You can do it yourself, yeah. Doesn't matter.
So, Blizzard maps, Frozen Temple, create.
By the way, can you search for the maps specifically? Like, whenever I have to open a map, it only works with the Blizzard maps. When I type in Frozen Temple, it doesn't load.
Sometimes I have this problem. Can we discuss it after the video, okay?
Yeah, of course. Now it worked. I just tried it. Now it worked for me.
The problem is they introduced a new bug regarding the arcade. I think we talked about it. And in the arcade, you just have to switch between replays and the arcade, for example. And okay. You won't make a drone scout, right?
I won't make a drone scout, no.
I think your overlord will fly above the barracks anyway.
Yeah, I thought the same, but let's just. I'm not gonna. If I would scout it with the overlord, I'm not gonna react with to it. I don't think it's necessary.
Again, guys, this is for the lower leagues, not the Masters League you've seen in the last videos.
We require more minerals.
We have to.
Game pause.
sorry. I built an eBay.
You built an eBay?
Yeah, sorry. I wanted to build a depot, but I built an eBay.
You built an eBay instead of a depot?
Yeah.
I've never heard that before. What the fuck?
Again, this is my first game and I didn't have my first coffee, but I'm just a bad player. So again, I'm building eBay. This shouldn't even be possible. Blizzard, fix it. Who needs an eBay at first building?
Yeah, I actually didn't know that was possible.
It doesn't
really make sense.
Day 9 Daily, where somebody got 2 gas and built an eBay and then turrets against the evil 2-minute Dark Templar build. This was a strange build, I can tell.
We require more minerals. We require more minerals.
Especially with the gases. Why did he edit the gases? Maybe for the turret upgrade.
Perhaps. Janitor fortress incoming. This guy only sent one SCV out to build the proxy barracks, which doesn't make sense at all.
I think you need to send out at least 2, yes.
So if you have seen on the minimap,
I would have seen it with the overload, but I will ignore it because on some maps you won't see it, on some other locations you wouldn't see it either. So we will just ignore that.
Do you know if it's played with with all 3 gas or?
It's 14 Rex, 14 gas, and then Rex, gas, and you delay the orbit command.
Okay.
You delay the orbital command to put down the third tracks.
But three guys in a gas.
Yes, and you add the second gas just after the third barracks. You need two gas to support three tracks Reaper.
I will try to build the bunker now. It's already building, okay. Okay.
We require more minerals. We require more minerals.
Difficult at all.
Yeah, you arrived kind of late. Now added the gas and the roach war.
I can
build roaches now.
Okay, we'll wait for the roaches and I'll try to make some kind of suicide for now.
Our forces are under attack. Spawn more overlords.
Yeah. Okay, we wait for the first roaches.
We require more rescue gas.
I do not have the multitasking for it.
We require more Vespin gas. We must place that on creep.
Your roaches are coming, or?
Yeah.
We require more Vespin gas.
Let's just jump out into the game. I think I executed it like a bronze or silver Terran.
Yeah, your Reaper was later than a standard Reaper timing.
And this is obviously someone who plays proxy Reaper will get the build order right, but
like the defense is the same. Like you play the basic build order. In lower leagues you get the spine. In higher leagues you will most likely skip the spine. And then the moment you identify it, it's mass reapers, you just add one gas and the roach worm.
Yeah, okay. Let's jump into the game. You have lead. I think the guy didn't enter my base at the correct timing as well, so we'll just... You know the early build order?
17 hatch.
A little bit lower, so just faster too, so we can see...
So I saw the SCV on the minimap for a brief second.
And you built an 18 pool. Was this a mistake?
It's not that big of a deal. 17 pool is better. I'm so used to 18 pool because I always get 18 gas, 17 pool.
Okay.
But 17 pool is better.
Okay.
It's just a bad habit because I'm used to playing hatch gas pool.
So another important step in this game is the Overlord flies to the natural of the Terran, so you can scout Is he complete all in, or will he at some point build a CC there and try to transition into a macro game, which of course he's way behind then. But you want to see this kind of move.
Game pause.
No, like at the natural, if the CC would already be done, it would be CC first. If it's halfway complete or like 3/4, it would be a Reaper expand. If it would start, then it would be a 2-rex Reaper aggression. And if there is none at all, then it's something else.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's why the first Overlord is important. That's why the Scout.
Now we again, see the... this is only cheese defense powered or from bronze to platinum. If you're in Diamond League, you can figure it out yourself, something what you want to do. But you see, against a weak Terran, it is no problem to defend it like this, to stay in the build, or you need gas anyway, you need a Roachborn anyway. So the game was over right now, because the Queens and the Lynx can defend, and you have built more Queens. No, 4 Queens, like always.
Like 4 Queens, like always.
You can... if the Reaper attack you, you can skip an inject, but you won't, I think.
Yeah, no, you can skip an inject for sure, it's not that big of a deal. Like, you have to build units anyway, you're staying on a lower drone count. I'm actually supply pack. Now building 4 overlords at the same time.
Yeah, I thought this couldn't be worth.
Yeah, that's why the roaches are a little later.
But you wanted to emulate a bronze player.
Yeah, but no, it shouldn't be a big deal.
Yeah, you did not get saturation for the complete basis because you did not want to play greedy, and you want to build attacking units like Lynx, Queens, and Roaches.
Yeah, of
to
course,
defend it.
Saturation doesn't matter in a situation like that.
Okay.
It's just about defending.
Okay, then I think this will wrap it up for this episode. So guys, again, timing and benchmarks, build the first 30 supply have to be perfect. If you're in silver and gold, they really have to be perfect, and you really have to practice it a lot. If you misplace the pool, or not misplace, I'm sorry, if you do not build the pool at 17 supply and at the right time, like I did with 400 minerals, this is really, really bad. And then you cannot build queens, you cannot build links, and you cannot defend, like you have seen, you cannot defend the Reapers really good or like it's supposed to be.
Yeah, definitely. So, see you guys next time.
See you guys. Gut. Dann bin ich mal ganz kurz auf Toilette und dann gehen wir in die Leder. Okay?
Okay. Jo, ich mach mir ganz kurz einen Kaffee. Gleich wieder da.
Alles klar. Ja, alles klar. Bis gleich. back again.
Jo, bitte da.
Perfekt. Dann würde ich sagen, straight into ladder. Oh, musste ich umloggen, genau. Ich mach mal Skype aus. Gut, ich mute mich mal und höre den. Ach nee, 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 nicht Stream anhören. Sorry, ist umgekehrt. Einfach loslegen.
Loslegen, oder? Ja.
Ja. Danach machen wir eine kurze Streampause und dann ein neues Video.
Okay, wir haben den Game. Hello guys, this is the Yoga Style 2.0. With me is Neoblade. Hello Neoblade.
Hello Mamba, it's Invader LE and ZVP. Zerg yeah. Versus Protoss. Master versus Master, okay.
We require more minerals.
What do you think would be a counter build by Protoss if he scouts correctly and react correctly to the to our build? He should build instantly a third base or react another way?
I think yes. I think he could hold it. I think the best thing to do is like getting an oracle. Using the oracle for scouting and map control, and then building two void rays behind it while establishing a third base. But the best thing how to counter it is just to have superior mechanics.
Okay.
Like, number one reason why we almost never lost, we haven't lost against Protoss yet, is because they execute their build orders bad. Their build orders aren't bad, they execute them bad.
Yeah. I remember so a game here where his force fields were quite good, but he often took the fight on creep, and he often took the fight on a large area where his force fields weren't that strong. So, yeah. And then his macro slipped. He became, he got, I think, he got 1,000 minerals, 1,200. And then, yeah, we just beat him with the macro and mechanics. Something against Terran I find very difficult on this map is taking the third map on the where the rocks are, because he can drop in the third and then use double medivac drop in the main and double medivac drop in the third and so on and so on.
Yeah, the third is very far away on this map. Especially these spawning positions where we are now, they are very bad for Zerg. The others are better.
Okay. So he scouts for a third base. Do we get supply blocked or
no, this is we aren't. This is intentional.
Okay.
Okay, so he builds two adapts. So we build four more links. Oh, I forgot the gases. Let's build the wall early. Oops. Game paused. I have no idea what this is. Neoblade, do you hear me? Sorry guys, our connection to Neoblade dropped for some reason. With the stream everything is still fine, I don't know what happened. Okay, Neoblade?
Yeah, sorry. Dropped Discord.
Well, was it you or was it me?
No, you was it.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. There was like a lot of error messages.
Yeah, I made a mistake, but it's we can just go then we can talk about Discord later.
So we killed all his adepts. Puts down a robot now.
He traded some of his adepts for some drones, but was it worthwhile?
It was definitely not worth it. Like, it should have been worth it. But he somehow managed to trade away 4 adepts for pretty much nothing.
You decided to build a wall early, so, but you only could block with queens, and the shades can yeah. pass through.
I don't know what I was thinking. The wall didn't really make sense at all.
A lane run by.
Oracle. Wow, that was kind of lucky. So we almost didn't scout our opponent, but we got all the information. He has a forge, he has a robo, he has 3 gateways, he's still on 2 bases, and he has an oracle. No second oracle, no.
So we should be able to defend with 1 spark brawler and 1 queen. Per base, right?
Yeah, we have 2 queens at the 3rd base. So because he's still on 2 bases, oh, now he gets his 3rd base.
Our push should deal damage, I think.
Yeah, we can definitely cancel the 3rd base. Up. One,
replace
rope speed.
Replace the killed drones.
Oh, yeah, so War Prisma. Oh, yeah, so War Prisma. That's interesting.
Since he attacks us, can we build some drones for our third base again?
Yeah,
or
we are already droning up.
Okay.
So we leave 3 roaches at home. And with the rest we will attack. Start 2-2.
Again, our creep spread is really, really good. Again, you did not use the Ravagers to kill the force fields. You just want to kill the sentries, right?
Yes, exactly. I need to fix some hotkeys after this game.
Okay.
But it shouldn't matter. Usually I cast...
Corrosive Pile?
Corrosive Pile with a different hotkey. Oops, we forgot that.
Normal plan, like defending until we have Ultralisks?
Yes. Let's... yeah, I've just threw it on the infestation pit. I'm a little bit scared of a counterattack, because especially in these positions, like it's just like two screens. So you can't be as greedy as you can be on some other maps.
Can we afford 2 links for the watchtowers if he builds a hidden base on the right hand side?
Okay, I'm gonna build. We have 1 link for this watchtower.
Okay, this is
should
enough.
Be enough. Yeah.
Yeah.
The watchtowers aren't important in those positions.
I know, but lower, sometimes they use the war prisma to fly straight through it, and yeah.
So it's pushing out now. We shouldn't do that.
Again, he fights in a strange position. Do some Protoss clear creep? Or do they do not care about it at all? Because our creep is...
They care about it less than Terran, but I think they still do.
Because I didn't have seen a Protoss who clears creep intentionally. If they have an Obzero with them and a large army and they move out, then of course the creepers gets killed. Oh, this doesn't look good for him.
Yeah, usually.
Concentrate on the fight, it's no problem.
Good Protosses would always clear creep, but creep isn't as important as in the TVC matchup. So Protosses are less focused on it.
Okay. When we will get a fifth base?
Just right now. Need to kill this creep tomorrow. And we can get a fifth. Sixth base as well. Storm.
Bad scouting on our part, or?
Yeah, well, the thing is, doesn't really help to scout it. Like you don't really scout for things like that. You see it in the army. You have enough time to react.
Okay. He's trying to cancel one of our bases, or what is the War Prism doing there?
Yeah, I think it's trying to cancel this base. And we can allow that to happen. We can do a run by into his third base.
Now we got Ultralisks. Oh, nice move. It distracted his main army a little, and yeah, now it's GG.
Yeah, I think it's GG. There's not much he can do. We have superior economy. Maybe we can scout for a hidden base. Whoops, our hydras are at the front. We don't want to throw the game by
doing a stupid mistake like
stupid
that.
Mistake, yeah.
That's really important that your Ultralisks are fighting. You build a good counter army to Ultralisks, but I don't think he has
enough. His army is strong, but his economy isn't. And we have just way more stuff. And that's GG.
Okay, let's jump into the analysis.
I think I played the early game very bad. I think I didn't play the build order flawlessly.
Okay.
But besides from that, it was a very straightforward game. Very easy.
Yeah, the most important part I've seen Platinum and Diamond League players doing wrong is they get greedy. They think they can kill the Protoss, and they just try to get Roaches and Hydras, or sometimes the storms hit so good and there are not enough Roaches in this army, and the Protoss can then build a fourth base and build enough probes so the game is equal again. And this I like very much about you. You scout all the time and you see, okay, the Protoss is doing this, it's doing that, and you can trade the army. Yeah, this was a mistake. The spine crawler should have been there. Do we have a spine crawler?
No, we don't have a spine crawler. Okay. We don't build a spine crawler anymore against Protoss and Terran.
Okay.
Only against Zerg.
No problem. But and this here would have been a spine crawler would have been okay, I think.
I don't think it would have helped. He would have or like in this specific scenario maybe it would have helped. But he could have just traded the adapts into my main.
The wall would have been complete with a spine crawler, would it not?
I think we need a third, a fourth evolution chamber.
Ah, okay. No, then it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, Invader is kind of a big wall.
And we traded 6 workers against 4 adepts. I think that's worth it.
As I said, like the adept should have done more damage. Our scouting in this game was very, very good, despite not actually moving our overlords a lot. Like
Yeah, but we've seen.
we just checked for the third base moments ago. We knew there was no fourth base. We knew there was a robo. This is a robo. We knew there was a forge, and we knew there was an oracle. And he's not gonna build phoenixes. We scouted everything in this game.
Yeah, this the placement of the Stargate was good for us.
Yeah, that definitely helped us, not building it right in our face. So the plan was attacking, like doing our normal push. It's a little bit weaker because we didn't play our build order very well. But the plan was right now is pushing the third base, canceling the third base while droning up our third base. This fortress might caught us by surprise.
We should have had some overlords there, right?
At the left side, yes, we could have. I'm not a big fan
It's a
of.
just a precaution. Oh, okay,
I'm not
speak.
a big fan of overlord spreading against Protoss.
Because of the phoenixes?
Because of phoenixes, yeah, like 90% of the time, Protoss will always go phoenixes.
Yeah, but I think from bronze to platinum. You can do that because if your scouting is that good and you see the Stargate is not producing anything like it is it's right now, you can just move the Overlord a little bit to the left-hand side, and then you see he's not producing anything. The fight is beginning, and again, you did not try to kill the force field, so your complete army could engage because you wanted to kill units.
Yeah, like the thing is, we would just trade a little bit. I think we could have done a lot more damage.
How you could have done a lot more damage?
With better micro. Like
Okay.
as I said in the game, I need to fix my hotkey. Usually I cast Corrosive Pulse with rapid fire and a
Okay.
different hotkey. And that didn't work on this account. I still forgot to include it on this account.
Okay. Yeah, we'll do that afterwards.
Yeah, I will do that before we start the next ladder game. It just helps a little bit. Now notice we didn't tech straight into ultras, because I was a little bit afraid, because in these positions I've previously said those spawning locations are very bad for Zerg. It's just like one screen, two screens, and then there's already the third base. Like it's literally two screens of rush distance when both players establish their third base. So usually we get like the infestation pit, 2-2, a third Evo, Hydras, overload speed, link speed. I was a little bit afraid of doing everything at once.
Yeah.
So we tech the Hydras first, and then when we were sure we won't die to a counterattack, we teched up the Ultras.
Yeah. He needs a fourth base. His army is a little bit smaller than ours, so he cannot. And his economy is too bad for a straight up trade fight.
Yeah, now we make this run by into his natural, and while we do this run by, we fight this army here, right here in the open. Like you
if,
can
if
kinda...
a zealot would have been placed there, you just would have killed it with your
just
run by.
Just kill it and move in.
And you did not go for the upgrade because
probes are
killing,
more important.
But yeah, killing Yuki Mamba killed 25 probes. You can you have the interface where it's shown. Yeah, okay, perfect.
He has only 50 workers now.
Yeah, and I think that's a major mistake. Oh, he builds probes again. Okay, this is better than do not replacing it, or you just go all in. But his upgrades are very, very weak.
Well, his upgrades are better than most protosses. Like he has +2 attack.
Yeah, I think, okay, it's okay for this stage of the game, but it's not okay against our upgrade compared to his.
Yeah, but that's one of the, I mean, we will always have superior upgrades with this style. Like, it's not that common to get double eBay so quickly.
Double forge, mm-hmm.
No, it's not double, our style is not as popular. Like, you won't see double EVOs very often.
Okay.
So yeah, this is one of the big strengths of our style. We will always have the better upgrades.
Yeah.
What
major mistakes in his mechanics in the complete game? What do you think?
Losing the 25 workers definitely sucked.
Okay.
Like that's just small moves. A good Protoss would have had a mothership core there. And if it cast just double fold Nova Charge on those two pylons, then I couldn't have walked in.
Okay.
Then his build order was definitely he could improve his build order. Should have done way, way, way more damage with his War Prisma. I think we never seen the War Prisma again, did we?
Only one time.
Yeah, like a good Protoss would use his War Prisma for the next, like, he wouldn't lose it for the next 8 minutes.
Okay, and use it all the time.
Yeah, and use it all the time. Like, you can use adepts to pick up drones. Like against a very good Protoss, that's like kind of the difference. In skill, like against a very good Protoss, you would need to build a spire and build 3 mutas against a War Prismas. That's like the best way to deal with War Prismas.
Yeah.
And because he's just not that good, we basically didn't have to do anything at all and still defended it.
Yeah, and he does not scout our fourth base. He thinks he's ahead in economy, and he did not replace the drones. And he thinks he can fight there, but we can completely remax our army, and he cannot. And yeah,
we have we have +3 armor. We had more army supply. It was just a numbers game.
Yeah. I think our creep spread could have been a little bit better in the end, because if we would have reached the watchtower completely with our creep spread, he wouldn't been able to move to our new bases on the right-hand side. But yeah, he was too troubled to defend our attacks against him. Okay. I have no more questions. Thank you, Mamba. And see you guys.
See you guys.
Gut. Dann.
Kurz den Stream stoppen?
Ja, mach mal gerade.